I can't tell you how many times I've cooked this tomato and basil bruschetta. This is one of my favorite things to fall back on. And considering the fact that it takes hardly 3 minutes to make, it's my absolute favorite. So to start off with, what I'm going to do is take three glossy, lovely, ripe tomatoes. I'm gonna cut them in half. Just looks so glossy, shiny and meaty as well. So if I'm actually pressed for time, I'm not gonna bother with scooping out the seeds. But today I have a couple of minutes on hand. So I'm gonna impale each of these tomatoes with a spoon. The reason why I'm doing this is going to be served on lightly toasted sourdough baguette. And I don't want the bread to go soggy. And when you season the tomatoes and they have the seeds in them, it's more likely to happen. So just let me get rid of the seeds for a minute. So the next thing is, I'm gonna roughly chop the tomatoes. You can be very precise, do it however you want. But as you can see, I'm not really particular about the size of my tomatoes. It's just going to be rough and ready. I think this should be enough. This should do for now. So to these lovely red, ruby red tomatoes, I'm gonna add just a small bit of basil. You could chop this, but I advise not to do that, because by tearing basil, you are only going to enhance the flavor and not bruise it. So, I mean, there's nothing better than fresh basil. If you can't find it, of course use the dried one, but I'm not gonna assure you that it's going to be the same. What I have already done here is I've toasted my bruschetta. These are still warm. So what that means is I can break a small piece of garlic to give these bruschetta three rubs. This may not seem like much, but what it does is impart lovely, warm, garlicky flavor. This is something the Italians always do. So I'm gonna take my platter here, place these bruschettas around my platter. Just however you want. I am entertaining three people and this starter course is going to be followed with a lovely pasta course. Before I pile on the tomatoes, I want to arrange these bruschettas quite generously with good quality extra virgin olive oil. And I suggest you use the good stuff here, because you can taste every bit of the lovely peppery olive oil. I'm gonna pile quite generously the tomato and basil mixture. I just love the way the basil tomato is gleaming at me. It's just beautiful. The combination, red on green, I tell you, very inviting. Be as generous as possible, how much ever the bruschetta can hold really. That is the bruschetta salted. Now all I have to do is, when my guests arrive, season it with some lovely sea salt and freshly cracked black pepper. And that's it, I'm ready to go.